I think every time you come through those doors, you can feel it. You can smell it, you can taste it, you know, it's just, it's something special. You know, I rant on about the BIDC, you know how close I am to the British Racing Drivers Club, but this is somewhere also very, very special. And of course, we've got very close links with the RAC. Sports cars were special for me because, unlike Formula One, I always seemed to be in the wrong car at the wrong time. Whereas in sports cars, I was always in the best car at the right time. I mean, a perfect example was this car here. You know, when I raced it, my first sports car race at Brands Hatch in 83, 35 years ago, it was a superb car and we won with it, you know. And I came back with Jaguar in 86 and we won with it. And the same with 91 with Jaguar and 92, winning Le Mans and winning the World Championship. I have to say, things that stick out in your mind in your career is the first time you raced, which was in a Formula Ford back in 75. You know, I went from earning 35 grand to 50 grand in 83, struggling to make ends meet, paying my own travel, my own accommodation, etc., etc., to all of a sudden getting a phone call from Renault at the end or the end of 83. And the numbers they were talking was just telephone numbers, you know, and they asked me to consider and decide later on. Well, you know, I was like a kid in a candy shop, you know. I'm going to drive for a manufacturer, one of the greatest manufacturers in Formula One, and be a works Renault driver with Patrick Tambay, one of my heroes in sports. And my father rang and said, you better sit down. And I'm thinking the drive's gone, when in fact he told me what the number was. Wow. And the number, you know, I mean, obviously it's not as important as the drive, but all of a sudden you realize that you were driving for a big team. What people have driven and what they think they've driven and how fast they've driven, unless they've driven a Formula One car, they have not driven a race car. Formula One car is another step from sports cars. I set out my career, obviously to win Formula One races, to win world championships, and to be recognized by my queen. That's something that was always going to be very special to me. And would I trade it? I never look back. I never say I wish I did. You know, there's a lot of people that wished they were Ayrton Senna. Unfortunately, Ayrton's dead now. So don't wish your life away. You know, I've got what I've got. I've made the best of it. And I'm kind of proud of what I've achieved from where I've come from. You know, I didn't have a silver spoon. You know, we came up from very humble beginnings to be a Grand Prix driver. Wow, you know, it's a storybook.
Well, I mean, the best driver because we had the best result, and winning races, coming up in the championship, is all about having the best car and the best driver. And of course, who I should have that year when I came fourth in the championship, it's my best result ever, was Ross Brawn and Derek Warwick.
Yeah, in the early 80s, in fact, when I started in Formula One, and Derek was one of the first drivers that I worked with, and we've had many great times together.
Brian Henton, and apparently Brian had taught him how to be a bit of an arse in a racing environment. So he was tough. I mean, he was not as cushy as what people might think, because he's such a nice person outside. You know, when he gets into the racing environment, he was pretty damn serious and pretty tough.
Thanks for the evening, Derek Warwick.